Hello, welcome to my channel, or welcome back if you've been here before. My name is Beth Ann. I have a few minutes this morning before I head out in my grungy clothes to collect data. So I wanted to just do a currently reading short update video with some books that are my current priorities. So we're going to start with ones that I've already started. So right now, first I'm reading Akata Warrior by Nnedi, which I've been buddy reading with Katya Weinert, and we've both had lots of life things happening, ups and downs, and so we've been reading this for like a month and are really barely into it. I sort of blazed ahead and read a bit in the last week or so, but we made like this first chunk. That was like all we did in like a month. So I do want to work on this and finish it. So this is the second in a series by Okorafor. The first book is Akata Witch, which I really enjoyed. In these books, we follow a young girl, Sunny. She's sort of on the cusp of becoming a teenager in the first book. And then in this book, I think she's 13. It doesn't really feel like you're following a 13-year-old, though, because Sunny has discovered that she is a person with latent magical capabilities, and in the first book she's been sort of inducted into a secret society of magic users, and it's a completely different sort of society from ours, especially in terms of the way that they treat children. They sort of throw children into the thick of things, they have to learn really fast and they have to do really adult things. Just learning about this magical world is really, really cool. And it is rooted in West African, specifically Nigerian, history and myth and legend. So it's just rich and beautifully written. Akata Witch had been a little bit of a letdown. I did talk about this in a wrap up, I think earlier, maybe my May wrap up or my April wrap up. And Nnedi Okorafor herself has said that the ending of the book didn't come together the way she wanted it to. There was something about like the publication and like back and forth with the publisher and whether it was going to be a series or not, I think. And so the ending for me was just sort of really a letdown in the mechanics of like how it came about and how it was executed. I think this book is likely not going to have that problem. And it is the second book in the series. And so far, you know, I'm halfway through. I do feel like I'm getting a little bit richer storytelling than in the first book, than in Akata Witch. So I'm really excited to keep going with this one because I'm enjoying it a lot more so far. And I think about halfway through the book, we're starting to get some of the setup for the inevitable big showdown at the end because this is a fantasy book. So I'm just really enjoying this and looking forward to that. All right. The next book I'm in the middle of, and it's so silly that I haven't finished, is Sir Gawain and the Green Knight, which is a very short book. It's an epic poetry, epic poem about Sir Gawain, who's King Arthur's nephew, and he sort of signs up for an epic, heroic task and is, you know, off to find the Green Knight. I just haven't finished it, even though it's beautiful and such a joy to read. So I read a little snippet of this in a Thursday poetry video a little while ago, so I'll try to link that below. All right, then two nonfiction that I'm working on. I am reading A Hobbit, A Wardrobe, and A Great War by Joseph Loconte with David Wiley. This is a buddy read. We're just about halfway through and we're going to try to finish it this week. And this is a book that focuses on J.R.R. Tolkien and C.S. Lewis, and specifically the role that their experiences in World War I played in shaping their respective epics that they're most known for. So in Tolkien's case, the Lord of the Rings epic, and in C.S. Lewis, the Chronicles of Narnia. And so far, reading this book has been really interesting. It's been a little bit tough to read, honestly, because it's been graphic, horrific descriptions of World War I. And so really to drive home the horror that Tolkien and Lewis both experienced in the trenches. I think Lewis was in the trenches at one point. Anyway, I haven't actually finished Lewis's chapter. I'm about to start a bit about Lewis. So I just came through like Tolkien's horrific experiences in the trenches. So it's well written so far. The writer is using a lot of quotes, especially from The Lord of the Rings so far, to bolster his arguments. And it also is about, so it's about the war. It's also about how how they came to view religion, sort of in part driven by the war, but also their cultural context, which was a time when especially British society was much less religious, was much more secular. And then, of course, Tolkien and Lewis ended up being pretty great religious thinkers. So yeah, so this is wonderful to read. It is sort of driving home for me the point of, I feel like I've been told by so many people things that The Lord of the Rings isn't. So like growing up, I heard from a lot of people, well, The Lord of the Rings is not a story about war. It had nothing to do with Tolkien's experiences in World War I. We actually have passages from his own letters where he's like, absolutely, it's about my experiences in World War I. And then I've heard other people talk about, oh, well, it has nothing to do, you know, with religion and his religious views. I was like, of course it does. I mean, you know, he like, it's all, I mean, I think everything, you know, we write and think, of course, is driven by our own experience. But he also, like, he had some things to say about these things in Lord of the Rings. So I do love reading sort of analyses of Lord of the Rings as a grown up, just because I was told things, you know, by teachers and by my parents and stuff about The Lord of the Rings. I guess people who had their own, you know, their own way of reading it. So anyway, so I'm really enjoying this book as well. Then the other nonfiction that I'm reading is Queer Palestine and the Empire of Critique by Sa'ed Atshan. And I started this in June for Pride Month as sort of my not happy Pride Month reading, because of course, you know, Pride Month began as you know, a symbol of the fight to end oppression of LGBTQ people, and they are still oppressed. And this book is really tough to read. It's excellent, but it is tough to read in a couple of ways. So for one thing, it's an academic work. So to actually sit down and read parts of it in the evening is brain work, which, you know, I'm happy to do, but this is a crazy time in my life, my personal life and my working life. And so that's been a bit harder for me to fit in. And then of course, it's tough topics. We're talking about queer folks in Palestine. We're talking about the queer rights movement in Palestine and among the global Palestinian solidarity movement. And it's tough because there's so much oppression. And of course, the Israeli-Palestinian conflict is like woven throughout this book. I mean, well, I mean, not even woven in, I mean, it's a huge component of this book. So yeah, this is a very tough read, but it is excellent. So so I would like to make more progress on this. I'm about halfway through, just based on the width. I think I'd made it through chapters 1 and 2, and then I think there's sort of two more substantive chapters and then a conclusion. So I'm about halfway through. All right. Then two fiction books that I haven't started yet. So the one that I think I'm going to start first is Kindred by Octavia E. Butler, which a lot of people on BookTube have been reading lately. It's a huge hole in my reading that I have never read any Octavia E. Butler. And so I'm very excited to start this. I'm going to be buddy reading it, sort of an overlapping buddy read. I'm going to start it with Stephanie Cohen, who's a extraordinary YouTube commenter, later this week. Well, actually, I mean, I'm supposed to have already been reading it. We're going to check in about a few chapters later this week, and then continue next week. And Katie over at Katie Reads and Rants also wants to read this, and we had been chatting about it. And so I think we might sort of overlap in our reading next week and going into August a little bit. So very excited to read Kindred. And then finally, the next book I want to start is The Mysteries of Udolfo by Anne Radcliffe, a Gothic classic, which I'm going to be reading with Amy over at A Star Reads. This was when we were also supposed to already start, but both of us are having a very busy summer, so we're sort of taking it as it comes. I love classic Gothic literature, so I'm very excited for this one. But the edition that I have is awful. So first of all, there's no title on the spine, and then look at how tiny this print is. It's minuscule. I'm totally screwed, and I'm too stubborn to like get another one, because I did buy this. I don't know what's going on with this edition, but I am looking forward to reading that. So brief update about what I'm currently reading. Hope you're all having a good week, reading good books, and I'll see you all in the next video. Thanks. Bye.